So now we shall start with practice set 9. So the first sum is negative 96 divided by 16. Write this in the form of fraction. Negative 96 divided by 16. Okay. Now after writing in fraction, we will look at the sign. Correct. That is, signs are correct because negative sign we need in numerator and it is in numerator. So now just check, write this in multiplication form. Check whether both the numbers are coming in any of the same table. Then if we will see, then both the numbers are coming in 16's table. First don't look at the sign, just write. 16, how much is 96? Very good, 16, 6 is 96. Yes, and 16, 1 is 16. Now here there is no any issue of sign, so leave it as it is. But here we need sign, is it, to get negative answer. So that negative sign, for whom to give? We have to give it for 6, because 16 and 16 will be cancelled. So here it will be negative 6. So 16 ones are 16 ones are, what is remaining? Negative 6 upon 1, that is equals to negative 6. Did you understand? Now we'll go for the next sum. First write it in the fraction. 38 divided by negative 57. But we all know negative sign should not be in denominator, it should be in numerator. So negative 38 divided by 57. Now think of such a table in which these two numbers will be there. You have to learn tables till 20, then you will get the answers quickly. So in which table are they coming? 19's table, yes? 19, 2's are 38 and 19, 3's are 57. 57 is positive, so here no need to think about sign. Here we need negative, so negative sign should be for one number. Then we will give it for 2, because 19 is being cancelled. So 19, 19 will go, then what is remaining? Negative 2 upon 3. So now we will go for the third sum. First write down in the form of fraction, 100 upon 60. Okay, now here there are zeros, so first cut out the zeros and make it into a simple fraction. 10 with this 10, what is remaining? 10 upon 6, yes? Now no sign, so it is simple division, yeah? So now tell 10 and 6, in which table do they come? So they come in 2's table, 2, 5's are 2, 3's are 2, 2 is going, so answer is 5 upon 3. So now we'll go for the next sum, that is 9 divided by negative 54. Write it in form of fraction. Negative 54, yes? So negative sign we don't want in denominator, so write down in numerator. Negative 9 upon 54. So which common table can we use here? 9. 9. 1's are and 9, 6 are. Here no sign because 54 is positive. So here we require minus sign. One number will be positive, other will be negative. Then we'll get negative answer. 9 will go with 9, 1's are, 9, 1's are. So answer is negative 1 upon 6. So now the fifth sum, 78 divided by 65. Write down in fraction. 78 divided by 65. No, both are positive, so no, there is no issue of signs. Now which table will these two numbers be coming, or they are in which two same table? They are in 13's table. 13, 6 and 13, 5. So 13 will go with 13. 13 ones are 13, 13 ones are 13. And what is our answer? 6 upon 5. Now the last sum what we will see, that is negative 5 divided by negative 5 divided by negative 315. We know when both the numbers are negative, they become positive. Yes? So this sign will go with this. So we are getting
5 upon 315. Now the common table is 5, because can you see at the units place 5, and this is 5, so 5 ones are 5. Here we have to find 5, how much are this 315 will also come in 5's table, test of divisibility. Units place, do you have 5? Means this 315 is coming in 5's table surely, but we don't know how much are, so we will divide and see. Okay, now 5, 6 are 30, 1 is remaining, take 5 down, 5, 3 are 15, so answer is 0. So what is the answer? 5 how much are? 63 are. So what we will write here? 5 into 1 and 5 into 63. 5, 5 will go. So what will remain? 1 upon 63. So I have solved 6 sums out of 10 sums. Remaining 4, you can see it in your textbook. First solve this 6 sums and then solve the remaining 4 sums on your own. So now we will go for the second question of practice set 9, that is, write 3 divisions of integers such that the fractional form of each will be 24 upon 5. Means you need to do 3 divisions, and after that means that 3 divisions, whatever you will do after doing it, its answer should be 24 upon 5. For example, first I will take 5th sum what we solved in question 1. What was that? 78 upon 65. Yes? Means what did we do? 13, 6 are 13, 5 are. 13 was common and our answer was 6 upon 5. Means 6 upon 5 is the simplest form of 78 upon 6. Means now this 24 is here in this place. Okay. So like this 3 answers you have to find. How did we get? Now if we'll go from down to up, what did we do? This 6 upon 5 we multiplied with one number. What was that number? 13 on both the sides. For 6 also you multiplied by 13 and for 5 also you multiplied by 13. What did you get the answer? 78 upon 65. Means now how this 24 upon 25 is here. Yes, now this 6 upon 5 we have multiplied by 13 and we got 78 upon 6. In the same way, if we take 6 upon 5, multiply it by 2, what you will get? 12 upon 10. 6 upon 5, multiply it by 10. 10, what you will get? 60 upon 50. So these are the 3 divisions which will give us answer 6 upon 5. Means now this in place of 6 upon 5 you are having 24 upon 5. Okay, so in mind what you did, this you can do in whatever 13 you have used, 2 you have used, 10, then you can do in mind and you can get the answers. So now we'll go for the solving of our main sum. So here we are having the fractional form, that is 24 upon 5, means it is positive. Yes, means we want positive answer. Now there are 2 conditions where we will get positive answer. Either both numbers should be positive or both numbers should be negative, then only we are getting positive answer. Okay, so whenever whatever numbers we will be using, they should be either both should be positive or either both should be negative. Now what I have taught you, suppose if we'll take 24 upon 5, if we have to multiply with same number, suppose I am multiplying by 2, okay, then what is double of 24? 24 2s are 48, 5 2s are 10. So our first division what we will do, that is 48 divided by 10, both are positive according to this condition. Now we'll take second number, for example 24 and 5, what numbers shall we take? Easy numbers we'll try, 10 and 10. According to second condition we'll try, that is if we take negative, then this also should be negative, this one also and this. So we can take it in this way,
So what is 24 tens are 240. What is 5 tens are 50. And both are negative. So answer will be positive. Now other condition. 24 upon 5. Okay. Into which number shall we multiply? Any number you can take. For example, if you are taking 12. Here also 12. If this negative you are taking, then this also negative. If this you are keeping positive, keep this also positive. See, the condition is here. Okay. Now, what is 12? 24 into 12, we'll do it. 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 0, 4, 2. That is 8, 8, 2. Means, both numbers are negative, answer will be positive. That is 288. Here both are positive, means answer will be positive. 5 12s are 60. So we got 3 divisions, that is 48 divided by 10, 240 divided by 50, and 288 divided by 60. Therefore, the 3 divisions of integers will be 48 divided by 10, 240 divided by 50, and 288 divided by 60, whose fractional form will be 24 upon 5. In the same way, we have to solve the next sum, that is same question, only the answer what we want in fractional form is negative 5 upon 7. Now in numerators, children, we need negative answer, and in denominator we need positive. So denominator will use both number positive, and in numerator will use one number negative, so that answer will come negative. For that what we will do, see, negative 5 only will keep everywhere, upon 7 into which number shall we multiply, but that should be same on both the side. For example, if we take 3 3, what will be the answer? 3 7s are 21, 3 5s are 50, and 1 is negative sign, it will remain here. Okay, now next, 5, negative 5 upon 7. Okay, what you will use? Any other number, for example 20. Here also you will use 20. So 5 20s are 100, 5, 7 20s are 140. Give your negative sign. Okay, and one more we can do, that is 5 upon 7, we want the answer, no? Negative sign will give for other number, what we will use here. Suppose we are using 5, give 5 here. Here we are using 5 only, no? Negative 5 only we will use. Then give negative sign here, because it should go, we want positive, no? So now negative 5 we are using. We want positive denominator. So both will be negative. Here only one will be negative. 5 5s are 25. 5 7s are 35. Here it will be positive, and here the answer will be negative. So the last statement will you write? I have given it in the first sum. I am just saying here the 3 divisions of integers will be negative 15 divided by 21, negative 100 divided by 140, negative 25 divided by 35, which will give, whose fractional form will be negative 5 upon 7. So now the fourth question in your textbook is, the fish in the pond below carries some numbers. You have to see it in your textbook on page number 14. Choose any 4 pairs and carry out 4 multiplication with those numbers. Then, or now you choose 4 other pairs and carry out division with this number. So I will show you one example of each, one of multiplication and one of division. You have to do remaining 3. So any numbers, I have drawn circle in your textbook, there are fish. So any number from this, 2 numbers you will take and one operation will carry on. For example, any number we can take. That is, which number shall we take? Okay, two negative numbers I will select. Negative 8 into negative 28. Okay, so two negative numbers, of course, our answer will be positive. write it front only. I don't have place, I am taking it down. So negative negative, of course answer will be positive. In rough work, do the multiplication. 8 8s are 64. 2 8s are 16. 16 plus 6, 22. So our answer is 224, and answer will be positive because both the answer signs are negative. One division I'll show you. Division sum we'll see. Suppose I'm taking negative positive 12 divided by, use the brackets, by negative 24. So how will you write positive 12 upon negative 24? Common thing, 12 ones are positive, means if you don't write sign, okay. Negative means 12 twos, and give that negative sign here. 12 12 will go. Our answer is 1 upon negative 2. But negative sign you can't keep in denominator, so answer is negative 1 upon 2. So you have to solve the remaining 3 pairs. You have to find here more 3, and for division also more 3, and complete the exercise or what is the practice set 9 properly in your books, whatever you are using for maths.